measures. Now, the next thing we want to do is we want to be creating some KPIs. Now, what are KPIs? Let's go to, we can see that there's a tab called the KPI over here. Okay. And it says that use this view to build or edit key performance indicators for the cube. So key performance indicators, as the name itself says, these would be some indicators which will tell us about the performance based on the data. All right. So if you go to the KPI tab, and let's try to take this away first. Okay. So give me a second. Let me just reopen this. Okay, so I've reopened this. We have a demo cube, so we can click on a demo cube, which is already open over here. So this is a demo cube. Okay, so now we are going to look at the KPIs. As we can see that it is one of the options given here in the editor window above, and we can just click on it and it will open this window. All right. So key performance indicators are not defined for this cube. As the name says, if you do not know key performance indicators, there are some indicators that we can create for the cube, as we will see, which will tell the business user about the performance of his organization based on the data that we have in the data warehouse. However, let's say the past year, what were the goals which were set for the organization and so on. So these are also like something like the milestones. Okay, so we can come to know about the milestones, about the performance of the organization. So now in this window, if we just hover over here, we'll see that there's an option to add a new KPI. So we'll just click on that new KPI. Okay. And once you click on the new KPI, this form will appear. So the default name it has taken is KPI, okay, which we can change over here. So we are going to calculate the profit margin. So let's call it the profit margin. All right. Associated measure group. So our measure group, associated measure group, if you click on it, it would be all. So let it be all. Or you can choose the fact table on which it is based. Now you can see that there are four major sections to this. There's something called the value expression. There's something called the goal expression. There's something called the status expression. And then there's something called the trend expression. Now all these, the values of all these values need to be provided so that the KPI can be calculated, and it needs to be written in the MDX syntax. MDX is nothing but multidimensional query language, okay, that is used to query your cube. Okay, so now you can see that there's something called the value expression. Value means what is the value of this KPI going to be? What is the value based on which we are going to calculate the KPI? So the value based on which we are going to calculate the KPI, let's go back to the measures tab, is the gross profit. Okay, so just click on this and drag and drop it over here. So measures.grossProfit, this is what we are going to calculate our KPI value on. Then the next part to this is the goal expression. What is the goal? Now we saw that there was some gross profit calculated for the data that we have. It was something like 0.19 something something something. All right. But what is the goal for my organization? So every year there are some goals set for the organization that we are targeting this much growth for the organization. It should be greater than 2%, it should be greater than 10%, it should be greater than 50% or whatever. So there would be something called the goal, which would be set for the organization. So let's say the goal that we are going to set for the organization is that the we should have a profit of at least greater than 70%. So 0.70. All right, that is the goal that we have set for the organization. We can keep on changing the growth. So this is your profit margin. So let's make it a little 0.30. Okay, that is my expression. I need to have a profit growth profit margin of at least 30% that I have set as my goal. Now with the help of this KPI, once we complete the KPI and view the KPI results, we should be able to see whether we have met the goal or not met the goal. Okay, but before that, let's configure some other properties that we want to see. Now the next section is the status. All right, a status. Status basically means how much towards the goal we have reached. Okay, so if I'm saying that my gross profit margin, I'm aiming to be 30%, but my profit margin is only 20%, so how much towards the goal have I reached, how much I have fallen back by, all this can be calculated by the status expression. So now writing the status expression, you have to write it in terms of an MDX query, and this is how an MDX query works. So I'm just going to copy and paste it for now, and then I'll explain you. So go back to the Microsoft Visual Studio. So this is how it would work. Okay, let's go back at the top and try to understand this query. So what we are saying here is, this is a simple case statement as it works in a SQL. So it will have various options, and if any of the cases or scenarios is satisfied, you will get that value as the output. So case when, first case, KPI value. So this is simply a function which is used to refer to the value of the KPI. Now the name of our KPI is profit margin, so you have to give it within double quotes. Okay, the value of the KPI by the name of profit margin. So the one that we have created is profit margin. What is the value of that? The value we have set over here, see. So this is a value. This is going to be a value of the KPI. So KPI value, that's a function. Okay, you have to give the name of your KPI, so value of the KPI by KPI goal. All right, the goal is over here. So 0.30 is going to be my goal. I could have also set an expression. So you do not want to manually change it every time going within the cube. Then you can create one more calculation over here and give it that value. So KPI goal of profit margin, the name of my KPI is greater than equal to 0.95, then the output would be 1. When this value is less than 0.95 and the value is greater than 0.85, so when it is between 85% and 95%, then the value would be 0, otherwise it would be minus 1. So the status can have values ranging from 1 to minus 1. So basically 3 values, 1, 0 and minus 1. And based on these values, it would calculate a status and represent it using this symbol that we have selected over here. So here in this case, it's a gauge signal. You have various other options. You can select shapes, traffic lights, reverse gauge, thermometer, cylinder, faces, and so on. So let's select traffic light so that it's easier to view over here. And I'm going to paste this query in the chat window as well, because for the first time that you write this, it's a little difficult. So what is the language in which we have written this? This is called the MDX. All right. So this is how your query looks like, and this is for the status, KPI status. Okay, so the next part is something called the trend. Okay, now what is a trend? If you hover over here, then select a trend graphic and then type an MDX expression that returns a value that is between minus 1 and 1. This value determines the state of the trend graphic. So again, this is a graphic that would be used to show your values. So it could be a standard arrow, status arrow, reverse status arrow, or faces. Let's choose a status arrow. And then I'm gonna have to write an MDX expression over here. So it would be something like this. And I'm again going to copy and paste because it's a little difficult for the first time that you write in. And I'm going to explain this query as well. So going back over here and clicking on this, this is going to be your trend expression. Okay, now let's go back and try to understand what we are going to do here. So what is trend? What would you say is a trend? Trend is basically a comparison of your organization's performance. Let's say currently the year is 2019. So I want to compare the performance on the 1st of June of 2019 with the performance I had last year on the same date. All right, so monthly performance probably. Okay, so till May end, what was my performance this year and what was my performance last year? And then what is the trend? Whether my performance has increased over last year, whether my performance has decreased over last year, or so on. So that is what is a trend, and that is what we have defined by this calculation over here. So you can compare, you make your comparisons over years. What was my trend over year compared to my previous year? What was my trend compared to my previous quarter, and so on. So these comparisons can be made and you will get an idea of how my organization is performing based on these various values. Now again, this has been written using the MDX expression. So let's see how it works. So again, a case statement. All right. And the first case is when is empty. And a few things you need to remember here is a function called the parallel period. Okay, so that is a function wherein it will consider a parallel period as your current year or date or semester or quarter. So it will consider a parallel period. That is a function you need to use. And the way you need to define this function is you need to give your dimension name. Now my dimension name, as you can see over here, is dim date, not dim, but my dim date dimension is joined within the cube using the three date columns. And if I see on the left hand side over here, I will not be able to see any dim date, but I'll be able to see a due date dimension, an order date dimension, and a ship date dimension. So I have to use one of these names. So if I want to compare based on the order date, so all the orders based on order date till May end of 2019, based on that, what was my profit margin? And what was my profit margin based on all the order dates till May 2018? That is the previous year. So you have to select one of your date columns, one based on which you want to make this comparison, and give that name over here, dimension name over here. So the dimension name is going to be order date because I'm going to be making the comparison over the order date column. Now this is date and year. What is this date and year? So if you go back to the dim date dimension and open it, then our dim date dimension has three columns, as we can see, and we created a hierarchy by year, month, and date, and we called it date in year. So that is my hierarchy name. So I'm going to make this comparison based on the hierarchy. So going back to the cube, I'm going to refer to this hierarchy. So this is my hierarchy name and the column within that hierarchy. I'm going to make the comparison based on the year. So this is going to be my year. And I want to be going back by 1 year. So that value you need to give here. So I'm going to make the comparison between my performance this year and last year. If I want to make the comparison between my performance this year and my performance 2 years back, then you have to change this value to 2. Okay, so this gives you the amount of periods by which you want to go back. So it is 1 in our case. And then this refers to your current member. Okay, so what is your current member? You have to pick that value, then you have to go back by 1 based on your year. That is what it specifies here. So might be confusing in the beginning, but you'll get to understand it. What is the function that we have used? Parallel period. You need to use this function to reference to your previous year's data or previous semester's data. You need to use a parallel year period, sorry. And then you have to follow the sentence wherein you define your dimension name, your hierarchy name, and then your column name based on which you want to go back, and your current member based on the hierarchy. Okay. And this is checking is empty. So when let's say my data starts from 2005, so I do not have any data for 2004. So when my previous year, the previous year based on this calculation will be calculated as 2004 for 2005, but I have no data for 2004, does not exist. So it would be returned as an empty. So if that is the case, then just give a zero value. That is what is being said here. Now this is just a syntax. When VBA is not equal to absolute, then starts the actual calculation. The actual calculation is KPI value, again a command, a function used to refer to the value of the KPI and the name of the KPI that we have created, profit margin, minus profit margin of the parallel period, okay, based on the order date, date in year, and the same syntax as we had used earlier, okay. So going back by 1 year based on the current member value, divided by the KPI value of profit margin for the parallel period, that is for the 1 year earlier period. If it is less than equal to 0.02, then give a value of 0. Now if the KPI value minus the KPI value, if the profit margin of this year minus the profit margin of the previous year is, okay, minus the profit margin of the previous year divided by the profit margin of the previous year is greater than 0.02, then the value would be positive. So it would be a positive trend. Then 1. If it does not satisfy any of these, then give a value of minus 1. So this is how you have defined the trend. So functionally, what is this doing? This is simply comparing your profit margin for this year, subtracting the profit margin from the previous year and dividing by the profit margin of the previous year to give you a growth percent in your profit margin. If that growth percent is less than 0.02 or 20%, then we are saying, okay, so there has been no growth. The trend is like almost the same performance. So these values you can change. You want to set it to 20%, to 100% or whatever, okay. If that growth is greater than 20%, I want to say that it's a positive growth, so I am going to indicate it by 1. Okay, 0 is no growth, 1 is positive growth, else minus 1. So if it is less than 20%, then it's going to be a negative growth. Okay, so that is going to be minus 1. So all both of these, your status, which is a comparatively simple expression, and your trend, they are all written in terms of your MDX expression. Okay. Okay. So I'll mail this query. I'll send you a mail and I'll put that query because the complete thing is not coming in the chat window. So I'm going to do that. Okay. So now that we have created this, KPI, let's save this KPI. Okay. Let's save this KPI, going at the top, save it, and let's try to deploy the cube again. Yes, it's again asking for the password, provide the password, and say okay. It's going to take some time to process, which is fine. And now you can see that the deployment is completed successfully and we have been transferred to this window. Okay, and I can see my profit margin in the KPI browser window. So the value is 0.13, goal is 0.3, the status is red, you can see, or you can also, when you hover around it, you can also see the value, which is minus 1, because we set the goal to 0.3, but our margin was only 0.13, so it's red. The trend is, there is, has been no change, all right, and the weight and all, we haven't added. Now we can filter as well. So let's select our order date. Date in year hierarchy equal to, let's go and select one particular year called 2014. Let's select 2008. We can select multiple years as well. Okay. And reconnect. Oh. Okay, let's go back. Order date, date in year equals, and let's select some all, select 2007. Okay, so it doesn't change. Save it. Okay, so it changes like this. So what we're going to do, select 2014. Okay. Okay, so this value has now changed. Let's just select the date. Okay, so now we have selected the year 2014 and the profit margin, you can see as in the KPI. The value was calculated as 1.27. Alright, so we have a good profit margin. The goal was set to 0.3, so we have exceeded our goal. That's why the status is now green. The trend is upwards. It's going up. Alright. So similarly, you can go back to your KPI. And you can change these symbols as well. So instead of traffic light, let's say we want a cylinder over here, and instead of a status arrow, we want faces over here. Let's save it. Go to back to the browser view, and this would be changed. Okay, so this is now green. This is a smiling face, so it's going up. Let's change it to some other year, 2010. Okay. Okay, so the values have now changed. The value, the gross profit was 0.07. The goal was 0.3. So we did not exceed the goal. So the status has become red. And the trend is still going up. So we are good in that case. Okay, so this is how your profit margin will be displayed. All right, now let's go back to the browser window of the cube. So this is the browser window of the cube. And we're going to reconnect. And let's open the cube in the Excel window. So this is the link. Just click over here. And the Excel would open up. Enabled. Okay. So now you can see under values, these are the three calculated members that we have created. So it has grouped them under values. These are the measures from the fact tables that we had. And now there's a tab for the KPI as well. So what we are going to see is the product hierarchy and the date hierarchy. Okay. And we are going to view our KPIs. So we can choose what we want to view. Alright, so when you view in your Excel using the pivot, these are the values you'll get. So you'll see these are the profit margins are all the red. Then here you have a green value, your trend is always upwards. Okay, green, red, and so on. So this is how you will get, you will be able to view in your Excel, in your cube. And this is the view that will be presented to the business users. Okay, so this is how the KPIs are helpful, because they convey the information about the performance of your, based on the data that you have in your data warehouse, and the visual representation, so it's easy to see. So if somebody just wants to check that four bikes, which year was profitable in terms of gross profit, then they can simply just look over here and see that this is the one in which I have had a positive gross profit margin, and that was the year of 2014. And then what were the values related to it? So visual representation and graphical representation is always more user friendly, and it will be easier to catch the eye of the user if there has been any changes in either the profit margin status or the trend. So this becomes a very important and helpful tool for the business users. So that is why the KPIs are very important. So now let's just close this. No, and go back to a cube. Okay. So now we have seen the calculations and how to create the KPIs, and these are the important parts in a cube that we need to know.